this has been a tough year for new broadcast shows, but one of the best new shows is All American on the CW. It's also one of the lowest rated broadcast shows on TV right now, so you're probably not watching it, but you should. It's a great show about a high school football star in Compton. He's recruited by the Beverly Hills coach to go over to his team. So you have this culture clash of inner city and Beverly Hills. The show's a lot like Friday Night Lights in that it uses football as a backdrop to really delve into a lot of emotional issues around this high school cast. It's not at that level yet, but it's definitely worth watching. I think there's a potential that it could get there.
You got the goods on and off the field. I knew it from the first day I met you, right here in this park.
Boy, I see it. You gotta go.
You're proud of where you're from, but tell me that going to Beverly isn't the best thing for you, baby.
You probably watched a lot of Netflix shows this year, but one show you missed was Everything Sucks, which was a coming-of-age comedy about teens in 1996 Oregon. There's a lot of shows that tackle this topic, but few do it in a way that managed to be as moving and as funny as Everything Sucks. Unfortunately, Netflix canceled it a couple months after it aired, and I know a lot of people are reticent to only watch a one-season show, but it is absolutely worth the journey.
Do you like me? What do you mean? You know what I mean.
Next up is The Good Fight on CBS All Access. Now, this is a streaming service that it's building its numbers up, but it certainly doesn't have the viewership of your Hulus and your Netflixes and your Amazons. The first season, it was really trying to prove that there was life after Juliana Margulies and life after The Good Wife, which is the show that spun off from. This season, in season two, it came into its own and it just focused on being one of the best shows on TV. It is the best look out there at what it is like to live and practice law in this crazy political environment under President Trump. It is a fantastic show, and it's worth subscribing to CBS All Access just for this show alone.
The world has gone insane, Liz. The news is satire. It's not real. The people blowing up grizzly bears have been put in charge of grizzly bears.
When you think about AMC, you're probably thinking about shows like The Walking Dead or Better Call Saul, so it'd be very easy to overlook this quirky gem, Lodge 49, which is about this dim surfer who's named Dud, and he ends up kind of stumbling across and joining this local fraternal order. It's unlike anything else you will have seen on TV this year, but it's an incredible journey that is worth going on, especially once you get to the conclusion in the final few episodes.
And I vow to abide in silence and mystery and accept the exile our knowledge requires.
Lux Nexus.
Facebook Watch is a very frustrating platform to watch content on, but it is worth it for one show and one show alone, and that is Sorry for Your Loss, which is a series that stars Elizabeth Olsen as a widow whose husband died unexpectedly a few months earlier and who is trying to cope with his loss. It is incredibly moving. The other thing that's interesting about this is that the struggles of her family and friends are just as compelling as her own. I wish the show was on any other outlet, but it's not, so I advise you to go to Facebook Watch and find Sorry for Your Loss.
You think you knew him, but you really didn't know him as well as you thought.
Do you know your husband's passcode to his phone?
Doesn't everyone? I mean, otherwise I'd wonder who he was texting that he didn't want me to see.
My sister's in free fall.
I just want to know things about him that I didn't get to know.